Hey, I'm John Wilson. I'm the Research Director for Southern Alliance for Clean Energy, and I joined Sam today here to tour the 2011 Solar Decathlon. We got to go in and tour about half a dozen houses, and first we're starting here with Purdue University, and this is a really conventional looking house. What's interesting is some of the things that you see right now in the picture, but you don't know you're seeing. The shingles on this roof are cool roof shingles, which reflect the sun's heat and help keep the house cool. But you can see they look pretty conventional, so you could put those on pretty much any house. Hey, so this is one of my favorite houses. I think, in fact, I'd say this is the best one we toured during the whole visit here today. This is Appalachian State, right there in the middle of Southern Alliance for Clean Energy territory. And some of the things I liked about it, the siding. You see there some southeastern poplar bark siding. It's very traditional product in that part of the country and available commercially. In fact, one thing that's interesting is most of the houses here use sort of off-the-shelf commercially available products. Now, Appalachian State, however, did take a little bit of a different tack. When we were inside talking with the mechanical engineer who put together the systems, we learned that a lot of their systems were custom designed, and they've actually got patents pending for some of their innovations. In other houses, they're showing how you can take stuff that's available today and put it to use right away. The coolest product I saw here today, I think, is the wax melting device in this house. And you think, what are you going to do with solar energy and melting wax? Well, they run solar hot water into a tub of wax, melt the wax, and then when you want hot water, you run cold water back through that wax and get the heat back out. So it's a great, elegant way to get hot water even when the sun's not shining.